Billionaires are flying to space, private companies are launching their own missions, and different countries are investing in space exploration.
The space economy is effectively everything happening off Earth for Earth. So that's satellites in space, that's people in space, that's missions to the moon potentially.
The space economy is projected to be a $1 trillion industry by 2040.
We are only just now seeing the very beginnings of a real commercial space economy starting to take flight.
The space economy already exists.
The real meat of the space economy right now is launching satellites and using those satellites for things back on Earth.
But there's more to expect from the space economy. More competition is bringing the price down. So younger companies and startups are doing more business in space. SpaceX already carries astronauts and cargo into space for NASA. Virgin Galactic and Blue Origin have plans to fly tourists to suborbital space. And there are even private missions to the moon. Many of these projects have been in the making for years.
It just happens to be this moment where a lot of these things are coming to fruition.
NASA is also shifting its role from providing services in orbit to buying them from other companies.
NASA is starting to help support companies that are hoping to build space stations that would basically fill in the hole that would be left by the International Space Station by 2030.
And other countries are buying goods and services from private space companies too.
The customer base is a challenge for the space economy because historically, governments have been the main buyer of services from these companies.
Right now, they're still expensive, and it's hard to gauge how many people will be interested in space tourism in the future. Another question is how to regulate space travel and commerce in the private sector.
The Outer Space Treaty from the UN is the governing document for how we're allowed to explore. But the interesting thing is there isn't a ton about how private companies are allowed to behave in space.
And finally, there's the technology itself, which is still
expensive, time-consuming, and extremely difficult. Big tech is a great example of what the space industry maybe hopes to look like in the future, which is this consumer-facing industry where everybody kind of has an interest in it and is learning about it every day.
But it's hard to say exactly what the space economy will look like.
The beginning of this new industrial rise, what you want are new ideas. And I think that maybe the biggest things to come from the space economy have not even really been invented yet.
But experts are talking about suborbital space travel, manufacturing goods and services a little farther up, and eventually reaching the moon and other planets.
I think that we are looking at a 20-year timescale for this economy that people are envisioning to come to fruition. And honestly, it might be even more than that. All of the work of the space economy is going to start becoming more visible.
Here's what you should remember. The space economy is expanding far beyond satellites today. There are still questions about its customer base, regulations, and technology. But the industry is expected to create $1 trillion in revenue by 2040. Watch what we're learning about climate change in the next video.